Hello students, welcome to our channel Learning Notebook. In today's video, we are going to do complete chapter of fractions. We are going to cover each and every concept related to fractions. So make sure you watch the entire video. But before starting with this chapter, let me tell you that we have made videos on every chapter of class 5 mathematics. We also have interesting worksheets and quizzes on each chapter. You can find all of them on our channel Learning Notebook. Also, you can see a list of all such videos on our website. The link to our website is below in the description box. So let's see what all topics we are going to cover today in this video. First, we will understand what is fraction. Then we will learn about types of fractions, proper, improper and mixed fractions, like and unlike fractions, equivalent fractions, and then we will understand how to convert improper fraction into a mixed fraction and vice versa. Next, how to make equivalent fractions, simplification of fractions, comparing and ordering of fractions. Next topic would be addition and subtraction of fractions. We will also cover multiplication and division of fractions, then how to find fraction of a fraction, then how to solve word problems on fractions. And in the end, I will give you a worksheet for your practice. So let's start and first understand what is fraction. Fraction means a part of a whole. Let's take an example. Consider an apple as a whole. Now, if you give half of this apple to your sister, then half of the apple remains with you. And each of this part is called fraction. Fraction is written in the form of numerator upon denominator, or we can say n by d. So what is denominator? It is total number of equal parts the whole is divided into. So in the example of apple, denominator would be 2, as the apple was divided into 2 equal parts. Now, what is numerator? Number of equal parts taken into consideration for a particular case is called as numerator. In the same example, the numerator would be 1. So our fraction would be 1 by 2. Now let's learn about types of fractions. In this section, we will learn about following types of fractions: proper, improper and mixed fractions, unit fractions, like and unlike fractions, and equivalent fractions. So let's first understand about proper, improper and mixed fractions. Let's first understand proper fractions. Look at this figure. It is proper for the large person to hold up the small person. So, in the same way, 3 by 8 is a proper fraction because it is proper for the large number to hold up the small number. So, students, it means fractions which have numerator less than the denominator, they are called as proper fractions. For example, 2 by 5, 4 by 7 and 9 by 11. These all are proper fractions because their numerator is less than their denominator. Now let's understand improper fractions with the help of this figure. Here, it is improper for the small child to hold up the large person. So, 8 by 3 is an improper fraction because it is improper for the small number 3 to hold up the large number 8. So, fractions which have numerator greater than the denominator, they are called as improper fractions. For example, 6 by 5, 9 by 7, 16 by 11, all these are improper fractions because their numerator is greater than their denominator. Now let's understand what are mixed fractions. Fractions which have two parts, a whole number, followed by a proper fraction are called mixed fractions. For example, fraction 1, 2 by 7. Here, 1 is the whole number and fraction 2 by 7 is a proper fraction. So, 1, 2 by 7 is a mixed fraction because it has two parts, a whole number and a proper fraction. Students, before moving further, let me tell you that we have a separate video on complete chapter of decimals for class 5. Here you can learn about unlike and like decimals, addition, subtraction, multiplication and division of decimals, how to compare decimal numbers, and also you can learn about word problems related to decimals. So I would suggest you to watch this video. You will find its link below in the description box. Now let's learn about unit fractions. Fractions with numerator 1 are called unit fractions. Let's take few examples. 1 by 7, 1 by 2, 1 by 16. In all these three fractions, numerator is 1. So all of these fractions are unit fractions. Next, let's learn about like and unlike fractions. So, what are like fractions? Fractions which have same denominator are called like fractions. For example, 1 by 7, 2 by 7 and 5 by 7. These three are like fractions because they have same denominator 7. Now, what are unlike fractions? Fractions which have different denominator are called unlike fractions. For example, 1 by 7, 2 by 8 and 2 by 9. These are unlike fractions because they have different denominator 7, 8 and 9. Students, we also have a very interesting working model to understand and learn types of fractions. I'm sure you will enjoy this creative activity. The link to this video is below in the description box. Now let's learn how to convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. Question is, convert 13 by 7 into mixed fraction. So here students, we are given with an improper fraction 13 by 7 and we have to convert it into mixed fraction. For this, we will follow two steps. In step 1, we will divide and find the remainder. So let's divide 13 by 7. 7 into 1 equals to 7 and 13 minus 7 equals to 6. Our step 1 is complete. Now let's move to step 2. Write in the form of Q R by D, where Q is the question, R is the remainder, and D is the divisor. So here the question is 1, remainder is 6, and the divisor is 7. So students, we have converted this improper fraction 13 by 7 into mixed fraction 1, 6 by 7. So this is how we convert improper fraction into mixed fraction by following two steps. Let's do one more question. Convert 42 by 11 into mixed fraction. So again, we will do this in two steps. Step 1 is divide and find remainder. So let's divide. 11 into 3 equals to 33. And 42 minus 33 equals to 9. So our first step is complete. Step 2 is write in the form Q R by D. So here we have found out that quotient is 3, remainder is 9, and divisor is 11. So students, we have converted improper fraction 42 by 11 into mixed fraction 3, 9 by 11. Now we will learn how to convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Question is, convert 1, 3 by 5 into improper fraction. So here we are given with a mixed fraction 1, 3 by 5, and we have to convert it into an improper fraction. First, students, always remember that denominator in both these fractions would always be same, which is the divisor. Now, to find the numerator, we will multiply divisor by quotient first and then add remainder to it. So here, divisor is 5, quotient is 1, and remainder is 3. So we get 5 into 1 plus 3 upon 5, which is equals to 5 plus 3 upon 5, and 5 plus 3 equals to 8. So we get the improper fraction as 8 by 5. So this is how we have converted a mixed fraction 1, 3 by 5 into an improper fraction 8 by 5. Let's do one more question. Convert 2, 1 by 7 into improper fraction. So students, as I told you in the previous question, denominator of both the fractions will remain the same. So let's write the denominator as 7. Now to find the numerator, we will multiply divisor, which is 7, by quotient, which is 2. And then we will add remainder 1 to 8. So we get 7 multiplied by 2 plus 1 upon 7, which is equals to 14 plus 1 upon 7, and 14 plus 1 is 15. So we get 15 by 7. So we have converted mixed fraction 2, 1 by 7 into improper fraction 15 by 7. Students, we also have a separate video on complete chapter of geometry for class 5. Here we have covered each and every concept related to geometry. So I would highly recommend you to watch this video. Now our next topic is equivalent fractions. Fractions which represent same portion of whole are called equivalent fractions. Let's understand it with the help of an example. The fraction for the shaded part in first circle is 1 by 2. The fraction for the shaded part in second circle would be 2 by 4. Can you tell me the fraction for shaded portion in the third circle? Yes, it is 3 by 6. And for fourth circle, the fraction is 4 by 8. So students, did you notice that the colored portion of all the four circles represent same portion of whole? Such fractions are called equivalent fractions. Now we will learn how to make equivalent fraction. We can make equivalent fractions by multiplying or dividing numerator and denominator by same number. Let's understand this with the help of examples. Suppose we are given with a fraction 1 by 2 and we have to write its equivalent fraction. So for this, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by same number, let's say 2. So 1 into 2 equals to 2 and 2 into 2 equals to 4. So 2 by 4 is an equivalent fraction for 1 by 2. Now, suppose we have to write one more equivalent fraction of 1 by 2. So what will we do? We will again multiply both numerator and denominator by same number, let's say 3. So 1 into 3 equals to 3 and 2 into 3 equals to 6. So 3 by 6 is another equivalent fraction of 1 by 2. So, in this way, we can find more equivalent fractions of 1 by 2 by multiplying numerator and denominator by same numbers like 4, 5, 6 and so on. Now, let's take another example. The fraction is 1 by 7 and we have to find its equivalent fraction. So, let's multiply both numerator and denominator by same number, let's say 5. So, 1 into 5 equals to 5 and 7 into 5 equals to 35. So, 5 by 35 is an equivalent fraction of 1 by 7. Now, let's see next example. We will find equivalent fraction of 9 by 21, but this time by dividing. So let's divide both numerator and denominator by same number, let's say 3. So 9 divided by 3 equals to 3 and 21 divided by 3 equals to 7. So 3 by 7 is an equivalent fraction of 9 by 21. So students, this is how we make equivalent fractions either by multiplying or by dividing the numerator and denominator by same number. Students, we have got a very interesting activity on how to find equivalent fractions of given fraction. You will find the link to this video below in the description box. Now we will learn simplification of fraction. Simplifying the fraction means reducing the fraction to its lowest form. So let's see how to simplify the fraction. Divide numerator and denominator of fraction by common factors till the fraction is in lowest form. Let's understand this with the help of few examples. The given fraction is 21 by 63. Now, students, as you can see, this fraction is not in its simplest form because 3 is a common factor of both numerator and denominator. So, to reduce this fraction in its simplest form, we will divide both numerator and denominator by common factor 3. So, 21 divided by 3 equals to 7 and 63 divided by 3 equals to 21. So, we get 7 by 21. Now, again look at this fraction carefully and you will find that 7 is a common factor between numerator and denominator. So, let's again divide this fraction by 7. 7 divided by 7 equals to 1 and 21 divided by 7 equals to 3. Now, we get 1 by 3. Is there any common factor between 1 and 3? No. So, now this fraction is in its simplest form. Now, let's see another example. The given fraction is 40 by 48. Now, what is the common factor between both of these? It is 2. So, let's divide both numerator and denominator by 2. We get 20 by 24. Again, if you notice, 2 is a common factor between numerator and denominator. So, again, we will divide by 2. We get 10 by 12. Now, is there any common factor between numerator and denominator? Yes. Again, it is 2. So, let's divide by 2 again. And we get 5 by 6. Now, students, there is no common factor between numerator and denominator. So, 5 by 6 is in its simplest form. Students, we can also reduce the same fraction 40 by 48 by dividing numerator and denominator by 8. Or you can divide numerator and denominator by 4 first and then divide by 2. We will get the same answer in all these cases as 5 by 6. Students, we have got a separate video on Roman numbers for class 5. This video has many questions and examples for your practice. You will find its link below in the description box. Now, our next topic is how to compare and order fractions. Now, students, let's understand how to compare like fractions. Since in the like fractions, the denominators are same, so we just need to compare their numerators. For example, there are two like fractions, 2 by 7 and 5 by 7. We have to compare them. Since they have same denominators, so we will just compare their numerator. 2 is less than 5. So, fraction 2 by 7 is less than fraction 5 by 7. Now, let's see the next example. Circle the smallest and greatest fraction in this group. So, here we are given with 4 like fractions and we have to find the smallest and greatest fraction. As I told you, in like fractions, the denominators are same, so we just need to compare their numerators. The smaller the numerator, the smaller is the fraction. Here, the smallest numerator is 3. So, smallest fraction will be 3 by 11. In the same way, the greater the numerator, the greater is the fraction.
So, the greatest numerator is 9. So, greatest fraction is 9 by 11.
So, students, we have learned how to compare like fractions. Now, see how to order like fractions. Arrange the following in ascending order. So, we are given with 3 like fractions, 5 by 7, 1 by 7 and 3 by 7. And we have to arrange them in ascending order. Here, the smallest numerator is 1. So, smallest fraction is 1 by 7. Next is 3 by 7 and then we have 5 by 7. So, now I am sure you must have understood how to compare like fractions and how to order like fractions. Now, let's see how to compare unlike fractions. Students, since in unlike fractions, the denominators are different, so we will use cross multiplication technique to compare unlike fractions. So, let's see what is cross multiplication technique and how to use it to compare unlike fractions. Let's compare two unlike fractions, 2 by 5 and 3 by 8. Since these are unlike fractions, so their denominators are different. So, we just cannot just compare the numerators. Instead, we will use cross multiplication technique. So, students, look here carefully. In the cross multiplication technique, we will first multiply 2 by 8 and then 3 by 5. So, 2 into 8 equals to 16 and 3 into 5 equals to 15. Now, since 16 is greater than 15, so fraction 2 by 5 is greater than fraction 3 by 8. Let's see another example. Compare 4 by 7 and 6 by 9. Again, to compare these two unlike fractions, we will use cross multiplication technique. So, first we will multiply 4 by 9 and then 6 by 7. 4 into 9 equals to 36 and 6 into 7 equals to 42. Now, since 36 is less than 42, so it means fraction 4 by 7 is less than fraction 6 by 9. So, students, I am sure you have understood how to compare unlike fractions. Now, let's learn how to order unlike fractions. Arrange the following in ascending order. We are given with 4 unlike fractions and we have to arrange them in ascending order. Here, look at these fractions. These 4 fractions have same numerators but different denominators. Since the numerators are same, we will just compare their denominators. Greater the denominator, the smaller is the fraction. So, here denominator 7 is greater than 5, 5 is greater than 4 and 4 is greater than 3. So, this means fraction having denominator 7 is the smallest fraction. Next, fraction with denominator 5 is greater than fraction 2 by 7. In the same way, fraction with denominator 4 is greater than fraction 2 by 5 and in the end, fraction with denominator 3 is greater than fraction 2 by 4. So students, while ordering unlike fractions with same numerator, do remember that greater the denominator, the smaller is the fraction. Let's do one more example. Arrange the following fractions in descending order. So we are given with four fractions, 1 by 4, 1 by 7, 1 by 2 and 1 by 9. And we have to arrange them in descending order. Here, again, notice carefully that all the fractions have same numerator but different denominators. So let's just compare their denominator. But remember that smaller the denominator, the greater is the fraction. Here, we have to arrange in descending order. It means we first have to find the greatest fraction. Greatest fraction will be the one which has smallest denominator. And students, look carefully. Smallest denominator is 2. Therefore, greatest fraction is 1 by 2. Next, denominator 4 is greater than 2. So it means fraction 1 by 4 is less than 1 by 2. Then denominator 7. It is greater than 4. So it means fraction 1 by 7 is less than 1 by 4. And next we have denominator 9, which is greater than 7. So fraction 1 by 9 is less than fraction 1 by 7. So we have arranged the unlike fractions in descending order. So students, now I hope you have understood how to compare and order unlike fractions. Students, we also have a complete chapter on measurement for class 5. Here, you can learn about measurement of mass, measurement of capacity and measurement of length. You will find the link to this video below in the description box. Now, our next topic is addition and subtraction of fractions. First, we will learn how to add and subtract like fractions. Question is, add fractions 7 by 45 and 8 by 45. As you can see, both these fractions are like fractions. Their denominator 45 is same. So we will just add their numerators. So we will do 7 plus 8 upon 45, as the denominator would remain the same. 7 plus 8 is 15. So we get the fraction 15 by 45. Now students, look at this fraction carefully. You will find that this fraction is not in its simplest form. So we will reduce this fraction to its simplest form. Both the numerator and denominator have common factor 15. So let's divide both numerator and denominator by 15 and we get the fraction as 1 by 3. So do remember to reduce the fraction to its simplest form. Now let's see how to subtract like fractions. Question is 17 by 33 minus 6 by 33. Again students, we will just subtract the numerators here because the like fractions have same denominator. So we will do 17 minus 6 upon 33. So 17 minus 6 equals to 11. So we get the fraction as 11 by 33. Now check if this fraction is in its simplest form. No, this fraction is not in its simplest form. So let's reduce this fraction by dividing with the common factor 11. So we get the answer as 1/3. So this is how we add and subtract like fractions. Now let's learn how to add and subtract unlike fractions. Question is, add fractions 1/3 and 1/5. Now students, here you can see both these fractions have different denominators. So these are unlike fractions. So to add unlike fractions, we first have to convert them to like fractions. And to convert them into like fractions, we have to find the LCM of their denominators. So LCM of 3 and 5 is 3 into 5 equals to 15. Now we will convert these unlike fractions into equivalent fractions of denominator 15. First unlike fraction is 1/3. So let's multiply both numerator and denominator by 5. So we get the fraction as 5/15. Second fraction is 1/5. Again, to make its denominator 15, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 3. So we get the fraction as 3/15. So now we have made both the unlike fractions into like fractions. Next, we will follow the same steps as we did to add like fractions. Now let's add the numerators of these like fractions. We get 5/3/15, which is equals to 8/15. Now students, as we can see, both numerator and denominator have no common factor. So this means this fraction 8/15 is in its simplest form. So this is our answer. Now let's see how to subtract unlike fractions. Question is 16/5 - 7/10. So here students, again, to subtract these two unlike fractions, we first need to convert them into like fractions. And for this, we have to find the LCM of their denominators. So LCM of 5 and 10 is 10. Now, let's convert these unlike fractions into equivalent fractions of denominator 10. So first fraction is 16/5. So to make its denominator as 10, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. We get 32/10. Now look at the second fraction, 7/10. It already has denominator as 10. So students, we have converted two unlike fractions into like fractions. Now we will follow the same steps to subtract the like fractions. So let's subtract their numerators. So 32 - 7/10. 32 - 7 = 25. So we get the fraction as 25/10. Now we can see that both numerator and denominator have common factor 5. So let's reduce this fraction into its simplest form. We get 5/2. 5/2 is an improper fraction. Students, never leave the answer as improper fraction. Always convert it into a mixed fraction. So let's do it. And we get the mixed fraction as 2/1/2, which is our answer. So students, this is how we add and subtract unlike fractions. Students, we would like to tell you that we have made videos on every chapter of class 4, class 5 and class 6 mathematics. We also have interesting worksheets, quizzes and working models on each of these chapters. So I would recommend you to check out our channel Learning Notebook. Now we will learn how to solve word problems related to addition and subtraction of fractions. So word problem is, mother purchased 4 1/2 kg of potatoes, 3 1/4 kg of onions and 1 1/8 kg of tomatoes. What is the total quantity of vegetables purchased by the mother? So here we are given with different quantities of vegetables purchased by the mother, and we have to find total quantity of vegetables purchased by her. So it means we have to add these three fractions. So first let's write the statements. Quantity of potatoes purchased equals to 4 1/2 kg. Now this is a mixed fraction. So let's first convert it into an improper fraction. We get 9/2 kg. Next, quantity of onions purchased equals to 3 1/4 kg. Again, let's convert it into an improper fraction. We get 13/4 kg. And then quantity of tomatoes purchased equals to 1 1/8 kg, which is equals to 9/8 kg. Now to find total quantity of vegetables purchased, we will add these three improper fractions. Now students, as you can see, these are unlike fractions. And as I told you previously, to add unlike fractions, first we have to convert them into like fractions. So let's find the LCM of their denominators. LCM of 2, 4 and 8 is 8. So now we will make equivalent fractions with denominator 8. So first fraction is 9/2. So to make its denominator as 8, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 4. We get 36/8. Now second fraction is 13/4. Here to make its denominator as 8, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. We get 26/8. And third fraction, 9/8, has denominator as 8 already. So now we have got the like fractions. So let's add them. For this, we will just add their numerators. So 36 plus 26 plus 9 equals to 71. So we get the fraction as 71/8. Now, as you can see, numerator and denominator have no common factor. So it means this fraction is in its simplest form. But students, this fraction is an improper fraction. So let's convert it into a mixed fraction. We get 8 7 by 8. So this is our answer. We will write the answer statement. Total quantity of vegetables purchased by mother is 8 7 by 8 kg. Let's see the next word problem. A drum full of rice weighs 41 by 6 kilogram. If empty drum weighs 13 by 4 kilogram, then find the weight of rice in the drum. So here we are given with the weight of a drum full of rice as well as weight of an empty drum. So to find weight of rice, we will subtract these two fractions. So let's write the statements first. Weight of drum full of rice equals to 41 by 6 kilogram. Convert it into an improper fraction and we get 241 by 6 kilogram. Then weight of empty drum equals to 13 by 4 kg, which is equals to 55 by 4 kilogram. Now to find the weight of rice in the drum, we will subtract these two fractions. So now to subtract these two unlike fractions, first we will convert them into like fractions. So let's find the LCM of their denominators. LCM of 6 and 4 is 12. Now let's make these fractions as equivalent fractions with denominator 12. So first fraction is 241 by 6. To make the denominator 12, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 2. We get 482 by 12. Second fraction is 55 by 4. Now here, to make denominator as 12, we will multiply both numerator and denominator by 3. We get the fraction as 165 upon 12. So now we have got the fractions as like fractions. So let's just subtract their numerators. So 482 minus 165 equals to 317, and the denominator 12 remains the same. So we get the fraction as 317 by 12. Now this is an improper fraction. Let's convert it into a mixed fraction. So we will divide 317 by 12. So we get the remainder as 5 and quotient as 26. So mixed fraction is 26 5 by 12. So this is our answer. Let's write the answer statement. Weight of rice in the drum is 26 5 by 12 kilogram. Now let's learn multiplication and division of fractions. First, we will understand multiplication of fractions. Question is, multiply fractions 5 by 6 and 9 by 10. So to multiply these two fractions, we will multiply numerator with the numerator and denominator with the denominator. Now we will simplify. 5 into 2 equals to 10. Then 3 into 3 is 9 and 3 into 2 is 6. So we get 3 upon 2 into 2, which is equals to 3 by 4. So this is our answer. Let's do one more question. Multiply fractions 3 by 5 into 1 by 6 into 2 by 3. So again, to multiply these three fractions, we will multiply their numerators and then their denominators. So let's simplify. 3 gets cancelled by 3, then 2 into 3 is 6. So we get 1 by 5 into 3, which is equals to 1 by 15. So this is our answer. Now let's see how to find fraction of a fraction. Question is, what is 1 by 2 of 4? So here students, we have to find fraction of a whole number, that is 4. And of means multiplication. So it means 1 by 2 into 4. If we simplify it, that means if we do 2 into 2 equals to 4. So answer is 2. Now let's do another question. What is 1 by 2 of 8 by 5? So here we have to find fraction of a fraction. As I told you, of means multiplication. So let's multiply. And as I told you, in multiplication, we multiply numerator with the numerator and denominator with the denominator. Now let's simplify. 2 into 4 equals to 8. So answer is 4 by 5. Now let's do one word problem related to this. Question is, capacity of a parking lot is 84 cars. 3 by 4 of the parking lot is occupied. How many more cars can be parked? So here students, we are given with the capacity of a parking lot and we are also given that 3/4 of this parking lot is occupied. And we have to find how many more cars can still be parked in this parking lot. So let's see how to solve this. First, let's write the statements. Capacity of the parking lot equals to 84 cars. Then 3/4 of the parking lot is occupied. So with the help of this fraction, we will find out number of cars already parked in this parking lot. For this, we will do 3 by 4 of 84. And I told you, of means multiplication. So let's multiply. So we have to do 3 by 4 into 84. Let's simplify it. 4 into 21 is 84. So we get 3 into 21, which is equals to 63. So 63 cars are parked in the parking lot. Now let's find how many more cars can be parked. For this, we will subtract 63 from 84. So 84 minus 63 equals to 21. So let's write the answer statement. 21 more cars can be parked in the parking lot. Now students, we will learn division of fractions. Students, to understand division of fractions, first, we need to learn reciprocal or multiplicative inverse. So reciprocal of fraction 2 by 3 is 3 by 2. It means we just need to inverse the fraction. Numerator becomes denominator and denominator becomes numerator. With this simple concept, we can divide fractions. Now, what is the reciprocal of 6? Students, in terms of fraction, 6 can be written as 6 by 1. So, its reciprocal is 1 by 6. Numerator has become denominator and denominator has become numerator. So now, with this concept, let's do division of fractions. Question is, find 7 by 24 divided by 5 by 12. So here, students, to divide, we will take reciprocal of 5 by 12 and multiply the reciprocal with 7 by 24. So reciprocal of 5 by 12 is 12 by 5. So let's multiply both the fractions. Multiply numerator with the numerator and denominator with the denominator. Simplify it. 12 into 2 equals to 24. So we get 7 by 2 into 5, which is equals to 7 by 10. So this is how we divide the fractions. Now let's do one more question. Find 28 by 11 divided by 14. So again, to divide, we will take reciprocal of 14 and multiply this reciprocal with 28 by 11. So reciprocal of 14 is 1 by 14. Because I told you, 14 in the terms of fraction is written as 14 by 1. So its reciprocal is 1 by 14. Now to multiply, let's multiply their numerators and their denominators. Let's simplify it. 14 into 2 equals to 28. So we get 2 by 11, which is our answer. Students, if you still not have subscribed to our channel, then do subscribe our channel Learning Notebook and make sure to press the bell icon. Now we will learn how to solve word problems related to multiplication and division of fractions. Question is, a bag contains 97 4 by 5 kilogram of sugar. How much sugar do 10 such bags contain? So here we are given with the quantity of sugar which one bag can contain. And we have to find quantity of sugar 10 such bags will contain. So it means we have to multiply. So let's first write the statements. Quantity of sugar in one bag is given as 97 4 by 5 kilogram. So this is a mixed fraction. Let's convert it into an improper fraction. 97 multiplied by 5 equals to 485 plus 4 equals to 489. So we get 489 by 5. Now number of bags equals to 10. So quantity of sugar in 10 bags will be 489 by 5 multiplied by 10. So let's simplify these. 5 into 2 equals to 10. So we get 489 multiplied by 2, which is equals to 978. So quantity of sugar in 10 bags equals to 978 kilogram. And we will write the same as answer statement. Let's see the next word problem. If a car travels 283 1/2 kilometers in 4 2/3 hours, how far does it go in 1 hour? So students, here we are given with the distance traveled by a car in some hours. And we have to find distance traveled by this car in 1 hour. So this means we have to do division here. So first, let's write the statements. Distance traveled equals to 283 1/2 kilometers. Let's convert this mixed fraction into an improper fraction. 2 into 283 is 566 plus 1 equals to 567/2. Next, time taken equals to 4 2/3 hours. Again, we will convert this into improper fraction. 3 multiplied by 4 is 12. 12 plus 2 equals to 14/3. Now, to find distance traveled in 1 hour, we will divide 567/2 by 14/3. So to divide, let's take reciprocal of 14/3, which is 3/14. Now let's multiply these two fractions. Multiply numerator with the numerator and denominator with the denominator. Let's simplify it. 7 into 2 equals to 14 and 7 into 81 equals to 567. So we get 81 into 3 upon 2 into 2, which is equals to 243/4. Now students, this is an improper fraction. Never leave the answer as an improper fraction. Always convert it into mixed fraction. So we will divide 243/4. So now let's write it in the form of QR/D. We get 63/4. So this is our answer. We will write the answer statement as distance traveled in 1 hour is 63/4 kilometers. Now students, I am giving you a practice worksheet. So students, this is the worksheet for your practice. This worksheet contains questions from all the sections of the chapter which I have just taught you. If you have skipped any of the part, I will suggest you to first understand that part and then attempt this worksheet. Do watch my other videos and share my videos and my channel with your friends and family. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.